Φίλες και φίλοι, έχουμε μαζί μας μια μεγάλη δόξα του ευρωπαϊκού μπάσκετ, τον Ρίμα Σκουρτινάιτης. Coach, welcome in Greece. After a great start in the season, during the last month, Himki is trying to find the rhythm and to be successful. After coming from three straight road losses, what do you think about the status that your team is right now? And what do you think about tomorrow's game against a hungry team in order to increase the chances to be in the playoffs?
For sure, this last month was really difficult for us. We got three games on our way and one on the home against Barcelona, one of the leaders in the EuroLeague. So for sure, we got some problems with the injuries. We lose our most important player, Alexei Shved, a couple of games. We lost the Yanis Tima, who is, okay, maybe he was not so good in Olympiacos, but he's playing really good in our team. It's not easy, especially if you get a double week and you play away. We have really strong local league. Sometimes you get like four games a week with a really strong teams. If you play every second day, it's difficult to push players to play maximum four games in a row. Okay, for Olympiacos, a little bit different. They play just EuroLeague games. And you know, once is good, they are saving the energy. Second one maybe is not so good, they are losing the rhythm of the game. So, and until now we don't know it's what is better, yeah, with a local league or without local league. So a lot of EuroLeague clubs is watching now the experience of Olympiacos for the next season, because I read in the newspaper Žalgiris is talking about the situation, Maccabi here also, to leave their national championships, just play EuroLeague. So now everybody looking for Olympiacos. Olympiacos is playing well. I saw the game against Panathinaikos. It was a really good game, and I think it's reason of the losing was the free throws at the end of the game.
Every year, Himki has one of the highest budgets in EuroLeague, but never made it to the Final Four. Do you think that it has to do with some no-pressure mentality that seems to exist in the team?
Everybody talking about the budget. It's budget not tells that his team is good. To make a team is not just the money. His Russian team's budget is bigger, because if you have possibility for 1 million to go to, for example, to Olympiacos, and if you want the same player in the Himki, you must play 1.5 for the just geographically problems. Next one, you know, you must get some experience of EuroLeague games. From 2011, then I start, we never get the possibility to play like five years in a row to play EuroLeague. We play one time, we are playing, then we are losing position, we're coming in two. To make a team in 1 year is very, very difficult. This season we changed 10 players. It's better maybe to play with a not so good level players, but 5 years together, than to get 10 stars and put them, yes, one day.
How difficult is to coach and to manage Alexei Shved? I mean, he's a great scorer, he's a great creator, but doesn't seem to be all the time a great decision maker.
Yeah, so he's our leader, it's no questions. I have no problem with him. Everybody understand you can make better decisions. He take a lot of risky shots, but a lot of times he helps us in the end of the games with a discount of risky shot. And if I start to stop this, maybe I don't know what kind of player I have from him.
Do you think that Himki will arrive at some point to be the best team in Moscow?
We're always trying, but it's difficult. You know the history of CSKA Moscow, you know how strong they are. Doesn't matter if they are changing some players. Doesn't matter, idea and spirit of the winners is never changes in CSKA. This season everybody is talking, we get a better team. Everybody is talking. Okay, sometimes on the paper you get a better team, but on the court sometimes it's different.
You played basketball until the age of 46 in Azerbaijan, and you're still in the game as a coach. Can you imagine your life, you know, without hoops?
My life, my hobby and my love is basketball, yeah? And if I need to do something for my family and for the basketball team, I say family is waited. And the first basketball and the second, maybe it's not right, but I'm like this.
You were one of the best shooters and scorers in the history of European basketball. Why do you think nowadays we don't have too many and we don't produce too many shooters?
You know, earlier we accounted shooter and sniper, like shooter and scorer. So earlier we have more, like, you know, Oskar Schmidt, Dražen Petrović, okay, me. We got Georgievich, so this was snipers, not a shooters. I don't know why, maybe this is talent from the gut and plus hard work, or maybe now it's not so much time to work on this.
Sarunas Jasikevičius from your country. He is the best coach or he was best player?
Both. He was one of the best players in Europe and he one of the best coach in the world, I think.
And Vasilis Panoulis needs 34 points to be the top scorer of all time of the history in EuroLeague. Your opinion about him?
It's one of the best players all the time what he's playing in EuroLeague. I'm full of his career like last 15 years. Yeah, I respect him very much. He's very good, very professional. I heard a lot of good things from the players about him. So he is living with the basketball. And for sure he will make this record. It's for him it's easy. So some games he can score 30 points. I don't think so he will do this tomorrow.